Okay, student, in our last video, we went through a very basic intuition of context-free grammar and context-free languages. So just I will recall very quickly and then we will go and doing some examples. So context-free languages are the languages that can be defined by some grammars. So every regular language can be defined by context-free grammar. And when we have a language which is not which is non-regular language, then we need to define grammar for that. The examples, the very basic example we saw was, for example, in the programming language, when you start some bracket, then you have to close it. If you start any bracket three times, then you have to have three closing, and there could be so many things inside. So this types of checking either the syntax is correct. We will give the program to our context-free grammar and the grammar will check if the following syntax is generated, and we will say that yes, the syntax is correct. For example, these brackets could be in C language, we use this bracket so many times. So whenever there is this bracket, it has to be closed. So these types of languages cannot be handled by deterministic finite automata, so we need some grammar rules, and the slides have the very simple example for that. And in arithmetic expressions, it is also very widely used. For example, if this is the grammar we have, and I write an expression, for example, x plus x multiply by x. So if I want to check either this type of expressions can be generated from this given example or not. Okay, this is not visible, so this is plus. So we will have to check. So in the slides we have seen that we need at least four things to define a grammar. First is the set of terminals. The sigma is called the set of terminals. Then we need a set of variables. Variables are also called non-terminals. And then we need the set of rules. And the last thing, which is not mentioned here, which is by default, whatever the variable appears on the first rule is default, the start variable. Else we will have to define that S is equal to E. It means if we have to start the if we start derivating, then we have to start with the start variable, which is E in this case. If it is not given, then whatever is the first rule, so that rule is our starting point. So for the sake of simplicity, I will write, this is rule number one, rule number two, three, four, five, and six. And our goal is to generate this string from the given grammar. If the following string can be generated from this grammar, then we will say yes, this can be derived. In case of DFA, we used to say it is accepted. In the case of context-free grammar, we will say the following string can be derived or it cannot be derived. So let's start. So we have x plus bracket start x into x bracket close. So, and we have two options to start with. The first is e plus t, and second is e to t. So because we have to start with the variable e, so we have only two options. Either we will start with this or we start with this. If we start with the rule number two, then we can never get the plus operator, because from e you can derive t, from t you can derive this, but you cannot get back to e, but e can get to t. And so we will start with the rule number one. So how to write it? There are many conventions. So you will say rule number one. So what is rule number one? E plus t. All right. So when we start deriving, then there are two again conventions or practices, either right hand side derivation or left hand side derivation. So the main objective of the goal is, when you have written the variables, so your goal is to eliminate all the variables and there should only exist the terminals. For example, e is a variable, we have to get rid of it, and t is a variable, we have to get rid of it. So to do so and to get our desired string, we will be very careful in doing that. So we will do either right hand side derivation or left hand side derivation. Left hand side derivation mean, if I start my left hand side derivating, that each time I will have to remove a variable from the leftmost corner. For example, in this case, I will first remove e, then after e, whatever the variable comes. So I will try to remove every non-terminal with a terminal. It means remove every variable with some set of a terminal. So, or we can do right hand side derivation. So if you can practice any, but if you start left hand side derivation, then throughout the process you have to be consistent. It is not the case that in the first line you do left hand derivation, in the second line you do the right hand derivation. So you should be very consistent. If you start left hand derivation, then you should end up with the left hand derivation. So let's try with the left hand derivation. So we can see the plus, after plus we need x here. So this e has to be converted into x. So we come to the grammar. This is x. To get x we need f. To get f we need t. To get t we need this. So I will apply rule number 2 and I will write like this. This should be the convention when you are writing and derivating the strings. So this e, whatever the variable is going to be replaced or removed, that has to be underlined. So I underlined e and apply rule number 2, and rule number 2 says that replace e with t. How you read this, it means e can be replaced with t, but t cannot be replaced with e. So instead of e, I will write t plus t. Again, leftmost variable is t. So now t, we have only two rules for t. If I use this rule, I will get multiplication, which I don't want. I just want that this t should be converted to f. For that, I will use rule number 4. This is rule number 4. And I will write f plus t. Okay. So after applying rule number 4, we get f plus t. And again, we have to remove f with t. So I will underline this. And I will apply rule number 6. From f, again we have two possibilities, but we will not go for this possibility, we will go for this. So applying rule number 6, this is x plus t. So okay students, our leftmost derivative we are following, and this here we get a terminal. This is a terminal, this is a terminal. So if we start from the left, this is not a variable, we cannot do anything. When we get a terminal, it means that cannot be further derived. So x is a terminal, we cannot do anything, because x, there is no rule for some x. Whenever there is x, it means you have to stop on that. So this x cannot be further derived. Plus is again the set of terminal, cannot be further derived. Now we have to derive t. So here's a tricky part. Now for t, we after this so till here we have successfully achieved, okay, this sub part of the string is successfully achieved. So now we have to achieve this one. For this we have to replace t with something. Okay, we are on t, then t, we have only two rules, t into f. If we use this rule number 3, we will get, for example, if I use rule number 3, though we will not be using rule number 3, if I apply rule number 3, then x plus this t will be replaced with t into f. But this is not something we want. We want the bracket first. So instead of this, we will use rule number t to f and then f to e. So we will use rule number 4. If you use rule number 4, then x plus will be carried forward and this t should be replaced with rule number 4f. Alright, so after this, So this F should be replaced with this E because we will get some brackets. So applying rule number 5. X plus this F should be replaced with E. So now the case is easy. This E, we have two rules. E plus T, which we don't want, we don't have any plus operator. We need multiplication operator. To get this, we need T. So rule number 2. Rule number 2. X plus rule number 2 says T. Okay, this E only will be replaced with T, so the bracket remains. So the T again, rule number 3, X plus T into F. So this was the variable we were trying to remove. Now the variable is T. This T has to be converted into X. This is very easy now. Applying rule number 4, X plus F into F. Okay, student, here is a point. I could replace this F with X first, but we cannot do this because we are doing left-hand side derivation. So first this T has to be resolved. So this T is replaced with F using rule number 4, and then applying rule number 6. This is X into F, and again applying rule number 6, X plus X multiply by X. So this time first I was, so we have to mention here the T was replaced, this F was replaced. After F, all these are the four terminals. So this F will be replaced, and once this is the final line, and this is the string we have achieved. So here we stop. So I hope this is clear.